you know, you're in great shape. You're doing well. And Rough and Tumble has
remarkably
done very well. It was number one on the classic rock chart.
Yeah, we didn't expect that. That came out of left field. And that's why we're here today and on the road. But it's a great way to spend your time. And it's great to have a number one record. I mean, I didn't expect it.
Well, I remember asking someone who'd been in the music business for a long time, like, well, you ever going to give up or are you ever going to just retire? I said, hey, that's what I do. It's what I do.
Well, yeah, but I seem to be able to hit all the notes and I enjoy singing maybe even more now because with all that life experience, you sort of like, you learn as you go along to leave things out. Generally, you leave things out as you get older. There's less means more. And as a singer, I've just developed and it's more of a joy to take a run at something and have the slight imperfections shine through, whereas younger I would be all like, oh no, it's going to be completely.
Right.
But now I seem to have a whole new take on singing.
Is it easier to write songs now?
Well, it's never easy, but there's no formula to it. You just close your eyes and away you go. There are professional songwriters that can sit down and come up with a pop hit.
Right.
But I can't do that. It just comes out of nowhere when it comes to me.
When you look back on your career, I know a lot of people my age think of the Babies. You guys had just some great hits there. Every Time I Think of You, Back on My Feet Again, for example.
Yeah.
And you were telling me about that. It's like, well, that band was great.
As a kid, look.
There it is. And an underappreciated band, I think, although a lot of people do appreciate it, and as you come back in time and look at it, you say, wow, that was some great music.
Yeah.
But you were talking about, you guys still never got out of debt with the Babies.
No, we owe the record company $1 million. So it's kind of like, I mean, everywhere I go, one of the first things people say is, love the Babies.
Yeah.
You know, even now. And that's sort of, we broke up in 1980.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like a fantastic thing. But we had some big hits, but it took a lot of money to generate that kind of touring. And we had videos and a billboard in Times Square and a billboard on Sunset Strip. And we had a lot of things given to us, but it was a real slog. But at the end of the day, it was an expensive proposition.
Yeah, which is remarkable. Now, you went solo. Change was a huge hit. Anybody remembers Vision Quest? It was in there. But Missing You, just kaboom.
Yeah, one minute I was kind of like, I was kind of obscure. I was like a cult figure. And then I was living in New York City the year before that came out, so I made my home there. And on the West Side, little old ladies, when I had the big hit with Missy, I came back from England, I was like number one. And it was great to see the neighborhood people kind of like, you know, so proud of.
Yeah.
And in New York City, that meant a great deal to me. But, yeah, it was like from relative obscurity to real worldwide fame overnight. You never prepared for that. It just comes out.
This song still, obviously, with iTunes and Napster and all that downloaded, still doing well with that song?
Yeah, you know, there's checks coming all the time, and I've never been bored singing it.
Yeah.
You hit the opening bars, and I sometimes get lost in it, and it's just, I'm there.
Yeah.
You know, it's about a certain person. I always see the same images. It's just, it's remarkable.
Because we worry about the Babies, you were still in debt, but this thing, you're cool with that.
You wouldn't believe. No, some of the stuff that goes on, you wouldn't believe it, but it's
but
made a lot
of money. But by everybody. You knocked Tina Turner out of number one, and then she's like, well, I think I'll record that song too. So she later recorded for her album.
I know. And you know what? There's a Tina Turner song on the new album, Sweet Red Island Red. I always wanted to sing that. Tina's been one of my heroines for years. So it was great to crack at that.
And that song's been covered by so many. I mean, it's the ultimate honor and respect.
Oh, big time. You know, I mean, to hear somebody like Tina sing that when you, you know, I used to watch the record going round with River Deep Mountain High and wondering how she did that in England when I was like 10. So to watch her sing something like that is just beyond words.
Well, others have influenced you, and you've certainly influenced others, that's for sure. So you are going to perform for us here in a couple of minutes.
I am, yeah.
Excellent. I want to remind folks, too, that John's going to be playing the Blue Ocean Music Hall in Salisbury coming up on Friday. So you get plenty of time now. Make plans. Go up and check out the show. You're going to have a great time. His band is solid. We're going to hear from him in just a couple of minutes. Look forward to that, John.
Thank you very
much.
We'll
catch up with you again in just a second. Going
to
take a break. We'll continue on the Fox 25 Morning News. More with John Wade on the way as well.
If you ever get lonely, if you need